Hi everyone, my name is Melissa van Dijk and in today's video I want to clear up another question that sounds simple but has somehow become way too confusing. And the question I want to answer today is, do you really need to wear sunscreen at home if you're using retinoids like retinol, retinal, adapalene or tretinoin or any other form of vitamin A product? And the short answer is no, not always. So you don't automatically need sunscreen just because it's daytime or because you used a retinoid the night before. What really matters is how much sunlight your skin is actually getting. And I want to demonstrate this in a few everyday relatable examples. So in the first example, I'm sitting on the bed in the morning and you can see the sunlight coming in. So the light hits my face directly. This is the kind of situation where sunscreen makes sense. So even though I'm indoors, regular window glass still lets some UV rays through. And those are the ones that contribute to pigmentation and faster skin aging. And just to be clear right away, it's not like sitting in a bit of sunlight through your windows is dangerous when you use retinoids. You're not going to damage your skin from that. But it's a bit like working out. My parents love to do that. They like to go for a walk and then go straight to the bakery to like grab some pastries or soda. It kind of cancels out the effort, right? I mean, you're probably using retinoids to target aging and sun damage. So if you're still getting regular sunlight on your skin, you're not really helping your skin to get the full benefit. So if you sit like this for 10 or 20 minutes or you work from home near a bright window for hours, that's real exposure. And in that case, putting on sunscreen or just moving a bit out of the direct sunlight is a smart idea. Now this doesn't only happen in the bedroom, it could also be when you're sitting on the couch in your living room or any other similar place and the sunlight is shining directly on your face. It's the same thing here. If you're using something like a retinol or retinal serum or cream, Differin Gel, prescription tretinoin, or really any other like form of vitamin A product, your skin gets more sensitive to light. So again, if you're in direct sunlight for longer periods, then it's better to limit that exposure, or essentially wear sunscreen at home. Now just to show you the contrast, if you have a small balcony like I currently have, or you're sitting on the terrace, or really whenever you step outside, sunscreen becomes essential when you are constantly using these products. Even if it's morning or cloudy, or depending on where you live, UV rays can still be strong outdoors. And if you're outside for more than about like 10 or 15 minutes, that's enough time for your skin to start reacting to the light. So yes, sunscreen definitely matters there, and that's really when it becomes essential to use. Okay. So now that I covered that, I also want to give you an example of the same spaces again, but this time there's no direct sunlight on my face. It's just normal daylight in the room, no direct light. And I think this is what most of us mean when we are saying we're staying indoors, and that's really where the confusion with this product starts. So you might think that this is where you need to use sunscreen, but no, you don't. The light is indirect and it's too weak to cause any real damage. Now I can talk about this from experience over a very long time, because during my acne experiment, which is still ongoing, but during the first 12 months, I avoided outer factors as much as I could and essentially isolated myself. I didn't wear any sunscreen because I was almost never exposed to direct light. I was constantly surrounded by that soft indirect daylight and my skin actually became very pale. All my freckles faded and my face turned almost white as snow, as you could see yourself if you've been following my channel closely. That's how I can confidently say that this kind of light is simply not strong enough to visibly speed up aging or cause sun damage. So really, sunscreen isn't something you need just because it's a new day or because you used a retinoid the night before. It's something you need when sunlight is actually reaching your skin for a meaningful amount of time. If the sun is hitting your face, whether you are outside or near a window, wear it. But if you're indoors, away from the windows, and there's no direct light touching your skin, only for a short moment, you're fine without it. The goal isn't to be scared of the sun or to make your routine harder than it must be. It's just about balance and understanding real exposure. Which means that a few minutes of soft daylight in your home won't do anything bad to your skin, even if you're using a retinol, retinal, adapalene, tretinoin, or any other like vitamin A product. It's the longer, more direct sunlight that matters, so don't overthink it. If you're indoors and the sun is on your skin, protect it. If not, you can skip it and enjoy your day. So I hope that this makes things like clear for you. Thank you so much for watching and I will see you in the next one. Happy skincaring!